KETV NewsWatch 7, chronicling the stories impacting our community. Stories making a difference. Stories that matter to you. This is KETV NewsWatch 7's Chronicle.
As a father of two young kids, what really drives me more than anything else is the future of the city and what kind of city they're going to inherit. For us to become the city of the future, we're going to have to tackle some of the big challenges that face our city, dealing with infrastructure, dealing with public safety, dealing with healing what I would say is the divide that exists within our city, east and west, north and south.
And former state senator Heath Mello believes he's just the person to do that, and that's why he wants to be the next mayor of Omaha. Good morning, I'm Rob McCartney. This is KETV NewsWatch 7's Chronicle. Today, the fourth of five shows dedicated to the mayor's race and the upcoming primary, April 4th. We're talking with each of the men and women running, Christopher Geary, Taylor Royal, Ian McHale, Heath Mello, and Gene Stothert. Final show will air 9 days before you vote. And all the chronicles with the candidates will be online at KETV.com. All right, this morning, Heath Mello. First, a few facts about him. He's a native Omaha resident, currently lives with his family in South Omaha's Robin Hill neighborhood. He graduated from UNL with a degree in political science. He was a senior aide to Nebraska Senator Ben Nelson. Then in 2008, he ran for the state legislature. We caught up with him during that first campaign when Mello said he was committed to his community.
I didn't choose to leave South Omaha. You know, my parents moved us around, but the neat thing was I chose to come back, which I think we need more people to do that.
He made it through a crowded primary 9 years ago, then focused on the general election, talking about the themes that still resonate today.
Trying to improve our quality of life, of protecting our neighborhoods, of helping the police and the state patrol and provide the resources they need to keep our streets and neighborhoods safe from gangs and graffiti and drugs.
Mello won that election, was reelected 4 years later, serving 8 years in the state legislature, and was, among other things, chairman of the Appropriations Committee, also served on the Performance Audit and the Rules Committee, and was a member of the legislature's executive board. Term limited out of the unicameral, he then set his sights on the city. And this past fall, Mello announced his intentions to run for mayor. And we were at the election commissioner's office in February as he turned in his official paperwork and talked to us about why he wants to run the city.
What kind of Omaha do we want in the next 10 to 20 years? It's something that I feel very passionate about in the sense that I think right now as a city can do better. And as mayor, I will bring a vitality, a vibrancy, and a vision to City Hall that's so sorely needed right now.
And joining me now to talk more about that is Heath Mello. Thanks very much for joining us this morning.
Absolutely.
So, what's your number one issue?
Well, Rob, I'd say my number one issue is addressing the city's crumbling infrastructure. Okay. It's the one thing I hear in neighborhoods across Omaha, no matter if I'm knocking doors in my neighbor in South Omaha or I'm out in Elkhorn, that people are concerned not just about their potholes, not just about the streets and the sidewalks, but people are talking more and more about the future of our infrastructure when it comes to transportation. And why we as a city have not had a real vision for the next 10 to 20 years when it comes to building that infrastructure to try to help provide more growth and more options for people to get around Omaha.
Well, give me an idea. What's your plan for the growth of that infrastructure? You're talking streetcar or what are you talking?
Well, that unfortunately seems to be the only thing on people's minds,
right?
Is the streetcar. And I've been, since I announced back in August, I've told everyone, look, the big vision I have for the city of Omaha is over the next 30 years of really trying to focus the city's growth inside the I-680 corridor and doing that through a modern transportation system that we see in other cities around Omaha, or around the region in the sense of Denver, the Twin Cities, Chicago, even Kansas City. And that's built around light rail. Mm-hmm. That's built around a light rail system that gets people east to west, north to south, and northeast to southwest, and everywhere in between. And at that extent, we then overlay our existing busing system on top of that light rail system, incorporate ride sharing like Uber and Lyft to make sure that people can get around Omaha without having to own a car. And then as well as making sure Omaha is a more livable more walkable city. That includes expanding existing pedestrian trails around Omaha, but more so ensuring we have more bicycle lanes. People can get around, whether it's downtown, midtown, or even out in Elkhorn, and feel that they can get across the entire city using a bicycle or using a pedestrian path, which right now we know is very, very tough to do.
When you talk about adding a bike lane, you're talking street widening then, or major, or rather very significant adjustments to the streets. How do you do that without completely throwing up all of the transportation that's going on now, and how do you pay for it?
Well, I think in regards to, we've seen some consultants come into Omaha and express to us that it's not an issue, so to speak, of widening lanes for us to do this, that actually Omaha has a considerable number of lanes in a lot of our major corridors that are actually larger than we realize. Okay. And to some extent, for us to be able to utilize those lanes in multiple fashions and formats is something that other major metropolitan areas around the Midwest are already doing. And we're just simply trying to catch up to create a more livable, walkable city. When it comes to financing, you know, I announced early on that similar to what we did in the state legislature, working with then Governor Ricketts and State Senator Jim Smith from the Papillion area, we created a state infrastructure bank, about $450 million. That funding and that mechanism is used to fund bridges and fund highway repairs and expressways, but also major economic development projects around Nebraska. And I said, we're going to take that model and really create that locally here in Omaha and take not just local dollars, not just state dollars and federal dollars, but we're going to combine it with private sector dollars and philanthropic funding for us to really be able to create a true public-private partnership in the city to fund not just the street maintenance, not just the things that we know we need to take care of, but really to be able to set the stage for this major infrastructure investment that we as a city are going to have to consider doing in the next 20 to 30 years to really compete globally, not just economically, but for talent across this country.
Let me ask you then about the sewer separation project. I mean, you're talking infrastructure there. That's a major, major cost that the city's facing.
Well, you know what? I would tell you it was the one thing that when I ran for the Nebraska legislature almost 9 years ago, it was something that was on the forefront of a lot of people's minds. And that's why I spent almost my entire legislative career working and advocating on behalf of the city of Omaha down at the legislature to make sure that the state became a partner with the city in regards to paying for this $2 billion project. It's actually the largest public infrastructure project in the history of the state of Nebraska. And I'm grateful for working with some of the Republican and rural colleagues of mine who didn't quite always see eye to eye of why the state should be partnering with Omaha. But we were able to build consensus back in 2014 on a major groundbreaking water piece of legislation that provided for the first time tens of millions of dollars for water infrastructure across the state of Nebraska. And as part of that compromise and that negotiation, we for the first time were able to get Omaha money directly back from the state of Nebraska to pay for the sewer separation project. Now, when you're talking about a $2 billion project, you know, a couple million dollars a year to some extent is not going to solve all of the burden that I know a lot of people
are picking
up.
It's like the interest on it, actually.
But more importantly, it was for us the groundbreaking step that was needed to be able to make sure that the state of Nebraska truly realized that they had to be a partner with the city moving forward. Okay. And I think that's the one thing moving forward as a city, we should be looking to expand on that relationship, not just with the state, but continually advocating on our interests at the federal level.
Okay, and looking back at your time in the legislature, back in 08, you said one of your jobs, one of your goals was to bring skilled jobs back to South O. Mm-hmm. Has that happened?
You know, we've seen that, and I would say to some extent, we've seen that through a number of expansion of programs and public-private partnerships with Metropolitan Community College. We've been able to see that with expansions of One World Community Health Center and their campus in South Omaha. And I think we've seen that more and more in light of other manufacturing-related companies. U.S. Cold Storage expanded their facility in South Omaha. But I would say we've got a lot more work to do. The one thing that South Omaha has been known for generations is not just being the gateway for immigrants and refugees to come and start over and really pursue the American dream, but really be a very entrepreneurial community where we see more small businesses develop in South Omaha than most other neighborhoods and areas of the city. And to be able to continue to see that being a focal point for us in the south side of the city, as well as the north side of the city, is part of the economic plan I've been talking about, that truly for us to provide more of an environment so that people who are either underemployed or unemployed, for them to look for ways to start their own business or work with another small business to expand, is opportunities right now that we can simply help kind of bring more people together and more of a collaborative approach through City Hall, we can really provide a lot more opportunities for these families and for these workers.
Talk about that in a little bit here, but I want you to characterize for me, if you will, Omaha's business climate right now.
You know, I would say Omaha's business climate over the last decade has been pretty stable. And I think a lot of that comes from the work we've tried to do in the legislature, partnering, working with the Greater Omaha Chamber of Commerce and a number of business and civic leaders, of focusing on ways to incentivize certain kinds of growth, of trying to focus on addressing the skills gap that we know exists in Omaha. But even then, we know we still have our challenges. And seeing major employers like ConAgra move their world headquarters, and just recently hearing more about the future of Gordman's in Omaha, that raises some red flags. And then for me, as Omaha's next mayor, I've been very clear that we need to have a mayor who's thinking about that business climate every single day, and someone who's not just outselling Omaha to cities around the country, but really trying to go out and sell Omaha to existing businesses in Omaha to make sure that those businesses feel they have a seat at the table in regards to growing our local economy and making sure City Hall is really adequately providing the service that they need for them to be able to consider their future business needs.
You know, a lot of businesses, they don't look necessarily to leave Omaha, but they may look to leave, to move around Omaha. One of the issues that came up is still is there is the Civic Auditorium. I mean, the original plans called for a tower and office space, and that those plans have changed. What's your plans for the spot?
Well, Rob, that's a great question. And about a month ago, I announced at my People State of the City address down at the former site of ConAgra's World Headquarters that I want to see that Civic Auditorium site truly become the city's first innovation district. We've seen that concept work in a number of other cities that have focused on the economy of the future and the jobs of the future. And what I'd like to see is an area where we bring our higher education institutions to partner with our technology, our startup companies, as well as some existing companies in Omaha that really are looking for the talent of the future and trying to build that partnership across the spectrum for us to be able to really create a magnet for companies and entrepreneurship and innovation that right now we don't quite have a facility or don't quite have a real geographic area in the city right now to do exactly that. And so in my mind, it's long overdue in regards to taking a real potential spot in downtown Omaha and bringing as many partners as possible to really build that talent base, but more so set the stage for future economic growth in this city.
You know, some people are looking at possible nonprofits. Would you look into something like that or green space, or do you want to really make sure you get something back on the tax rolls?
You know, I've been very clear that I'm open-minded to seeing, you know, partnerships with other nonprofit organizations that maybe want to come and part of this space. But truly, I think if anything in my mind, creating an innovation district really needs to be focusing on what we can do to bring entrepreneurs, innovative businesses, innovative organizations, and what we can really do to tap into the creativity in Omaha. And I think more so than anything else, that would be my vision for that area of the city.
Your television ad talking about City Hall says, and here's the quote, City Hall should work just as hard as Omaha families do. Are you saying people in City Hall don't work hard?
Well, I would say to some extent, the mayor's office over the last 4 years have made a lot of promises. And unfortunately, those promises haven't been kept. And I equate that to some extent working hard to build relationships and working hard to build consensus. And that's something that I've proven to be able to do in the Nebraska legislature. It's not easy to do. It's actually, I always say, a lost art of politics. It's usually, it's my way or the highway is the way most people take it. And it's the easier approach to take when you're governing. And I've taken the hard way, which is bringing people around a table, finding ways to come up with what the problem is, and then spending as much time as we need to build consensus to solve that problem. And so as mayor, I would work harder in the sense of trying to make sure that these big challenges facing our city, that we're going to work just as hard every single day to not just solve them, but do it through a consensus building process.
Some people may look, though, and say, well, Heath Mello's been with the Democratic Party. I mean, you represented a specific political party for years. How can you be a consensus builder if you are so geared toward one side?
Well, Rob, that is a question that no doubt I've been asked a number of times over my lifetime, and I think you simply look at my record in the legislature of being the first Omaha State Senator elected chairman of the Appropriations Committee in 64 years at the age of 33. And I happen to be the first Democrat elected to that position in 62 years. And that was done in a supermajority Republican legislature. And so I've tried to explain to people working with a supermajority Republican legislature, two Republican governors, we've been able to tackle a significant number of issues down at the state level. And it's in part not just to my style, but also the approach I take, which is to build consensus and to hear people out regardless of their political view or their political persuasion.
What about fundraising for your campaign? And we have latest campaign finance reports. It shows first 2 months of the year, you nearly tripled the amount of money that Mayor Stothert raised. However, she still has more on hand. If you look at actually at the scene there, the on hand, she has about a couple hundred thousand more. What do you attribute that to?
Well, I think as much as anything else, people across Omaha have been excited about our campaign's vision for the future. And it's something when I announced that, I said that Omaha's doing okay, but we are really missing out right now in a big vision that really makes Omaha a more aspirational city. That we've got to be able to tackle some of the basic challenges as a city, but we're not thinking not near enough to the long term. And a lot of people across Omaha have been excited about that message. They feel that they want to see a mayor who can tackle both potholes and plowing snow, but also try to make sure that more people have health care and to address some of the sustainability issues that involve climate change and what we're doing to make Omaha a greener and cleaner city. And I think we've seen an outpouring of support from Republicans, Democrats, business leaders, labor leaders across the spectrum, because they're excited about not just our vision, but they've seen what I've been able to do in the legislature, working with diverse audiences, working with diverse coalitions to really solve big problems.
Okay. Well, we're going to talk a little bit more about those your plans for the future, including your new five-point plan you talked about. I'm going to take a quick break, but we will continue our conversation with mayoral candidate Heath Mello with KETV News Watch 7's Commitment 2017. Chronicle continues. You're watching KETV News Watch 7's Chronicle, and joining us this morning is mayoral candidate Heath Mello. And Mr. Mello, talking earlier, you announced actually you have a blueprint, a five-point blueprint for Omaha's future. Briefly, what is the idea behind that?
Well, we just recently announced a blueprint to make Omaha neighborhoods safer and stronger. Mm-hmm. And a couple of those ideas that really resonated, not just with me working with neighborhoods in South Omaha for a number of years, but talking with people across Omaha, is really looking for ways to change the way the city engages people with the city budget. And that's why we, as part of that blueprint, created a participatory budgeting pilot project that puts money in each city council district and allows residents to determine how that money gets spent on a local project, a local park, a local sidewalk repair, bicycle lanes, whatever the residents in that district decide to do with the money. That's the decision they get to make. And it really tries to incorporate more citizen feedback in more real time in the city budget process, along with a plan that I announced of making sure neighborhood associations and neighborhood leaders play a significant role in all major boards and commissions inside City Hall, just to make sure that we're really promoting as much civic engagement as possible across the city.
Are you talking about people from each neighborhood association being on a commission? Is that correct?
Or not each neighborhood association, okay, but just making sure neighborhood associations or neighborhood leaders are represented on boards and commissions.
I want to clarify that, because people can also check out more on your plan on your website.
Absolutely.
I also want to ask, annexation is an issue. We have Omaha added 7 SIDs over the past year. What's your plan on annexation?
Well, I've been very clear that I'm going to take a much different approach than the mayor did in regards to annexation. And part of that is just what I'm hearing across Omaha right now as I go knock on doors. And the concern is that we're having challenges right now keeping quality city services up to a certain level that people expect with the amount of taxes they're paying. And right now, the more you annex, the more you're putting stress on all of your city departments. But particularly, we've seen it in regards to public safety, in regards to increased response times across the city. And that's something that, as I've said very clearly, I want to put the brakes on our annexation policy right now, take a step back, and be able to make some determinations and do some independent analysis on existing city services, both in public safety as well as other areas of the City Hall, to make sure that we're meeting the demands and meeting the adequacy that people are expecting of us moving forward.
You are not happy with how the mayor picked the new fire chief, Dan Olson. Some complained that she picked him even though he wasn't on the list of finalists. I know there's legal action pending. What's your problem with it?
Well, I don't want to get too in the weeds in light of a lawsuit currently in place in regards to that process. But when I announced, my concern was that more so that any time that you pick someone who ranked 6th out of 10, and to some extent that person leapfrogs into the top position, normally people would ask, how did that happen? And that just didn't quite feel right with me. It didn't quite seem right. And to some extent, any time I hear the city or hear the mayor specifically say, this just reconfirms a decision I made earlier, that usually raises some red flags, not just in my mind, but a lot of people across the city's mind.
Would you keep Dan Olson as your chief?
Well, I think as much as anything else, current city code is the chief works for whoever the mayor is. It's not in a political position, and that's one thing I've been very clear, that I do not want to see a fire chief or the police chief and Chief Schmatter become political appointees and or be put out there as political actors in the political campaign system and or in doing any kind of political work for a mayor moving forward.
So then Chief Schmatter then would be protected, maybe?
Both positions. Right. I think that's a one difference between me and the mayor. The mayor came out and said she wants those positions to be political appointees. I feel seeing a police chief work not just on behalf of the mayor, whoever the mayor is, but more importantly, work on behalf of the taxpayers across the city, both Republican, Democrat, independent taxpayers. That's very important, and that's what separates Omaha from a lot of other major cities in the country.
When he first took the job, Chief Schmatter told me that how he wanted a fifth police precinct, and that they've been working at it, looking at it for years. Just announced that that's going to happen. Your thoughts, are you curious about the timing of it, or what?
Well, I announced about a month ago, Rob, that I wanted, as mayor, I would make sure we'd have a fifth police precinct by the end of 2019. And I was the first candidate, actually, both including the mayor, to put an actual date on my decision. And I think, as much as anything else, putting those kind of dates and putting out that kind of accountability is sorely needed right now in City Hall. It's easy for people to come out and say they want to do something or unveil a proposal in the middle of a campaign when they've had 3.5 years to actually do something. It's different when you put an actual time frame on it so that people can judge whether or not you've been successful or you haven't kept your word.
What's your plan for North Omaha development?
Well, the one thing that I've been talking extensively about in the north side of the city is really trying to continue to build that entrepreneurial ecosystem that's needed to be able to create more small businesses and help people start their own business. But I think it goes further than that. I think in regards to some of the work that I've done in the legislature, we know that there's a considerable number of people who are coming out of our criminal justice system, who are ex-offenders, who are having a difficult time finding jobs and difficult time finding housing. And to some extent, we got to be able as a city to focus on ways to find new employment strategies, not just for our ex-offenders, but for those that we know need more skills to be able to fill some of the existing jobs we have as a city. That's why I've announced creating a mayor's manufacturing partnership to be able to help residents, not just in the north side of the city, but all across Omaha, to be able to partner more with local manufacturers to fill their workforce needs, but also be able to help them expand by looking for new markets for their products and goods. But on the north side specifically, I've been really focused, more so than anything else, of building stronger partnerships with our community college system, Metropolitan Community College, and also looking at existing small business development centers so that we can do everything we can to make sure that anyone who wants to start a business can start a business and be successful in the north side of the city.
Are you getting good feedback from it?
I am so far. A lot of people feel that is the real immediate job opportunities we have in the north side of the city, but I've also been very clear that we have to revisit a major issue that I'm afraid the mayor sideswiped too early in her administration, which is to go back and try to restart the North Omaha Industrial Park. It's something sorely needed to be able to bring that heavy industry manufacturing base back to the north side of Omaha to bring more investment, to bring more jobs, and that's something I'd like to do.
Okay, very good, and we'll look at that later on, but I want to come back with a few final thoughts. First, a reminder, your comments are an important part of the show. If you want to be heard, email those comments to news@ketv.com. Want to hear from you, and we will be right back. Welcome back to KETV News Watch 7's Chronicle. For the past 30 minutes, we've been talking with Heath Mello, who wants to be the next mayor of Omaha. Don't have much time left, but Mr. Mello, I want to give you a minute to make a final plea to your voters.
Well, thank you so much, Rob, for the opportunity to be with you here this morning. And as much as anything else, my name is Heath Mello, and I'd like to be Omaha's next mayor because I believe we can be a better city. I believe that we need to begin building the Omaha of the future, and that's a more welcoming, more connected, and more innovative city. I think what we've seen right now in Omaha is that we know that our streets are crumbling, violent crime, property crime is going up. We've seen major employers leave Omaha, and the restaurant tax, unfortunately, is still out of control. And the one promise I've been making to people across Omaha is that okay is not good enough for me right now, that we need to become a much better city moving forward in tackling the big challenges that we know face Omaha. It's not just obviously those issues, but we've got to find ways to reinvent City Hall to make sure that we're providing more quality services for a more adequate tax base and to ensure that people feel they're getting a value for their dollar. We also have to address what we know is a significant challenge with public safety and crime. So with that being said, I'd appreciate your consideration on the April 4th primary and the May 9th general election.
Good. All right, Heath Mello, thanks for being here. Now, next week, we're going to wrap up our series of five Commitment 2017 Chronicles with Mayor Gene Stothert. We'll have that show, this one, and the ones we did with Ian McHale, Taylor Royal, and Christopher Geary online at KETV.com. Just look for the Chronicle tab on our homepage by clicking on the menu bar. Don't forget, the primary is April 4th. You can actually vote early starting tomorrow, March 20th. Deadline for doing that in person at the election commissioner's office is Monday, April 3rd. I'm Rob McCartney. Thanks for watching. We'll see you back here next Sunday morning for KETV News Watch 7's Chronicle.